In the last part, we have studied about how biotechnology has helped humankind by making insulin, PCR, all those things. Now, when we use biotechnological processes, there are certain steps involved when you have to do a biotechnology process. As for example, when you do a physics lab experiment, you have to meet all the requirements or you have to do all the requirements. Similarly, when you do a biotech experiment or biotechnology experiment or per se genetic experiments, there are certain steps involved in a biotech experiments. Okay, and these steps are common for all the experiments. Now, the first step, if you have to do any biotech experiment, the first step would be identification of the desired gene. When I say desired gene, the gene on which you want to work. It could be anything. In the case of insulin, it could be gene which produces insulin. Or if you want to work on hormones, it could be the gene which produces the hormone. So anything. First step is identification of desired gene. Now, when you have identified your desired gene, you have to cut the DNA or cut the cell or plasmid, whatever it is, and obtain your desired gene. And the cutting has to be done with the help of restriction enzymes, which are nothing but scissors, bio scissors. Now, when you have done the cutting and obtain your desired gene, the third step would be to put that desired gene or your gene of interest into a plasmid. Now, when I say a plasmid, plasmids are nothing but vectors or vehicles. Now, the use of vehicle, normally we use vehicles for what purpose? To travel from one place to another. Similarly, vectors in biotechnology are used to carry biomolecules from one place to another. So now, you take your desired gene and put it into a vector. Yeah, plasmids. There are various vectors available in biotechnology. It could be PBR322, PUC19, PUC18, whatever, depending upon your gene of interest. Now, once you have put your gene of interest on the vector, now you have to introduce your vector plus gene of interest into a host organism. Host organisms are organisms which replicate faster. In this case, it could be E. coli. Since the generation time of E. coli is 10 to 20 minutes, so as E. coli replicates, your gene of interest is also going to replicate. So now, let us study the steps. Let us once go through the steps which are involved into genetic engineering or the steps of biotechnology. Step number one, identify the DNA with desired gene. Step number two, cut the DNA with restriction enzymes or endonucleases to obtain gene of interest or the gene of your choice. Step number three, put the gene of interest into vector or vehicle, which could be PUC19, PBR322, or any plasmids of your choice. The last step, formation of recombinant DNA. Thank you.